Hi friends, I'm so glad you're here today because this video is right for you. No matter what kind of online video content you're creating, I'm going to share ninja tips that are going to work for podcasters, for YouTubers who want to create pre-recorded content, for coaches or anyone who has a membership site, and of course, for live streamers. And be sure to stay to the end so I can share with you the new feature and that you get all of my StreamYard ninja tips. One of my favorite StreamYard features is the ability to multi-stream. That means that we can go live on different platforms at the same time. Under the Destinations tab over on the left, you'll see that you can add Facebook pages, groups, profiles, Twitch, LinkedIn pages, events, and profiles if you've been approved for streaming to LinkedIn. YouTube channels, you can add multiple YouTube channels, and Twitter, and also custom RTMP. But it's beautiful that you're able to stream to these different locations at the same time. This way, it enables you to build an audience across different platforms. In addition to all the destinations that we can add, you'll find that there's another feature that can really come in handy, and that is this record only option. Now, this is great for creating pre-recorded content that you can upload to all your various destinations as a pre-recorded video. So I love that you can just record only inside of StreamYard. Oh, I'm gonna sneak in another tip while we're here. I don't have to be on camera, so I can click stop cam. This is great for podcasters. And you have an avatar that can show, and you can edit that avatar. So all you have to do is upload a different image. I'll choose this one. And then you go ahead and enter your studio that way. Be sure you add yourself to the broadcast. And you can also have your guests come in. They don't have to be on camera if they don't want to. Who knows, they could be having a bad hair day or a messy background, but you'll still be able to either live stream or record a podcast episode. Be sure to head over to the settings cogwheel over on the right and check off record a separate audio file for each guest. That will help you when you're editing your podcast files. Now let's talk about how we can use banners in StreamYard. You can easily display banners up on screen. You can even add in a scrolling ticker, which will give the agenda or calls to action for your audience. You can also use the banner to add talking points. And you can change the colors of your banners to match your branding. And we also have different styles and shapes of banners that you can use right inside of StreamYard. Here's another great tip. If you want to have multiple camera angles, so what you would do is to take this invite link down here, email it to yourself, and open it up on your mobile device. First thing you want to do is make sure you have your earbuds plugged into your mobile device so that you don't get any audio feedback. Then you would just open it, and I've already done a video here on the channel talking about how to use StreamYard from your mobile device. So once you're in the studio with your second camera, then you would just add that to the stream. So this would be great for an overhead shot. It's also great if you really want to do behind the scenes and show your studio or something like that. But here's another tip that you can do. I wanted to share with you that you can also swap placement. So if I wanted to make that second shot the bigger main shot, then all I have to do is drag and drop. And that goes for if you had other guests in, you were doing an interview or you were doing a panel. Remember, you can have up to 9 people, including yourself, that makes 10, and you can swap folks' positions around just by dragging and dropping. The other thing that I want to remind you is that you have this green room function. So if there are people that are in the backstage waiting to come on, let's just say I wasn't on yet. As the host, I could just chat in here and I could just say, I'll bring you on in a minute. And then your guests would see that little private green room chat. And then when you're ready, you can bring your guest on or whatever the case may be. Let's head over to the branding tab on StreamYard so we can take a look at how we can upload a countdown timer for our intro and for our outro. This gives us a clean run of show. Now, I already uploaded the video. Notice how my mic is muted. Now, we can stop that intro anytime we want as the video is playing, but I also want you to notice how your mic is muted when that intro is playing. And then also to end out a clean run of show, you would leave with an outro. And that's just simple video animation that I created in Canva. Well, friends, there's one last ninja tip that I want to share with you, and it's one of the newest features that's been added to StreamYard. And that is that we can now give people a link to a past broadcast. So for example, I could download my recording, I could share and embed it, or I can restream that out to a different channel, or of course I could go back into the studio, or I could view this on YouTube. So I used StreamYard for a meeting, which is another great thing that you can do. I did it as an unlisted video on YouTube. But what I want to do in order for those folks that were not able to attend the meeting, they can watch it on the website. All I have to do is grab this embed code, embed it on my website, or I could just share the link with them after they've signed up for the email list. And so there you have it. You are now officially a StreamYard ninja. So go out there and have fun. Happy streaming, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.